Hi students, so today we are going to talk about simple interest and compound interest. In fact, I would suggest that you should see that 10-minute video on this very chapter where I spoke about the basic concepts. What is interest? Why do we want interest? Why the bank gives you interest? You know, all that basic concepts are cleared in that first video. I would request to go back to that chapter for a better clarity. So today I'm going to touch upon the topic, which is simple interest. Right? Simple interest. Now, if you see the first page of the book, they have given the formula for calculating the interest, which is P into R into T upon 100. This is the formula which is mentioned in the book. Now we need to understand what P means, what R means, what T means, right? And why there is 100 in the denominator. So in the last video, we had taken one example that if you have 1 lakh rupee and you go to the bank, right? The bank offers you say 6% rate of return and you give this money to the bank for say 1 year, right? You have the option of giving the money to the bank for 1 year or 2 year or 3 year. It all depends upon you. So what is 1 lakh? 1 lakh is the principal. What is 6%? 6% is the rate which is offered to you. And what is the 1 year, 2 year and 3 year? This is the time for which you give the money to the bank. This is what these pay. This R and this T means. Now, how come there is 100 in the denominator? I'll just come to it. But where is this formula coming from? So if I have to calculate what is that interest I'm going to get from the bank, so what I'm going to do is 6% of 1 lakh. So how am I going to calculate? 6%, right? 6% is 6 upon 100 into 1 lakh. 6% of 1 lakh. This is the interest which I am going to get after 1 year, which is multiplied by 1. So now you see, this is the actual formula. This is the P, this is the R written in percentage, and this is the T. So what we have been always doing is nothing but written in the form of a formula, right? And this is what in the last video also we calculated as 6,000 rupees. This is what the interest is. How do you calculate 1,000 rupees? Two zeros, and 6 into 1,000, you get 6,000 rupees. So this is how the interest formula, which looks like a complicated formula, has been derived, right? So I hope now you understood where is this I, simple interest, coming from. Now, there are many more formulas which are there just to confuse you in the same chapter. Now, this is also not a formula. After doing this calculation, you realize that this is also not a formula because this is what how we calculate I. So now you don't have to memorize it. You don't have to ratify it. That what is interest? Interest is nothing but principal, that lakh rupee, rate of interest, which is 6%. For what time? 1 year, 2 year, 3 year. So if it is for 2 years, I'll make it 2. If it is for 3 years, I'll make it 3. It is that simple. So this is where the formula is derived from. Now the other formulas which are mentioned, for example, they have mentioned the formula for P, which is they have written as I into 100. Upon R into T. Now, is it very difficult formula? Should you memorize that principal is equal to I into 100 upon R into T? No, this formula is not required. Similarly, there is a formula which is mentioned for time, which says that I into 100 upon P into R. Is this formula required to be learned? No, this formula is not required to be learned. Why? Because if we only know this formula, I can find out these two expressions also. This is nothing but the basic maths. If you see this formula, this is a basic maths of cross multiplication. This is a basic maths. What is I? I upon one. So I'm doing a cross multiplication. If I have to find P, I'll take 100 and I and R and T in the denominator. This is how we solve the equation, right? This is a cross multiplication. This is an equation. I can do a cross multiplication. So if I have to find P, this is I into 100 divided by R into T. I into 100 divided by R into T. This is how the formula is. So you don't have to memorize this formula separately. Coming to the time, where is time? This is time, right? This is time. How can we find out the value of T? Again, a cross multiplication. I into 100 divided by P into R. I into 100, if this has to go on this side of the equation, divided by P into R. Where this is where what it is written. I into 100 divided by P into R. So these are the only three formulas, right? These are the only three formulas. But what I'm saying is even this formula is not required to be learned because we know how to do percentage calculations. This is how we calculate the interest. And this is nothing but written as a formula. I hope you understood what I'm trying to say. This is the start of the simple interest. I'm going to take many, many questions on the simple interest, but this concept needs to be very clear. See you in the next video.